Our today's topic is the game played between Alireza Proza and K. Sasikaran in FIDEchess.com Grand Swiss, which is happening nowadays in 2021. And in this game, Alireza Proza played a marvelous game, I would say that. The game started with e4, e5, knight f3. Knight c6, all the standard replies, bishop c4. This is the start of the Italian game. Bishop c5, and this is start of the Gicciopiano. The name of the opening, the Italian game variation. And this is all the standard moves. This c3 and developing this pawn over here, immediately threatening this center by playing the move d4. Knight f6 was played and Alireza Proza played the move d3. Instead of it, he could go for directly this d4 variation. We could have a look at over here just what happened. But if white plays immediately d4, then e into d4, c into d4, and bishop b4 check. After that, bishop d2, bishop into d2, and knight bd2. This might be the sequence of the moves, and this is called the Greco Gambit. The opening actually changes. This is the same, still the Italian game, classical variation, but it is called the Greco Gambit. So we go back to, these are all the standard moves in the opening. We go back to our main move which was played in the game, and that was d3, castle, d5, black side. Okay, if you are not opening the center, I am going to open it with playing the move d5 immediately. You had the time to open the center with the move d4, but you did not do that, so I am going to open the center now. So e into d5, knight into d5, rook e1, bishop g4, and this pin of g4 on this knight f3 is a very I would say that tricky one actually. And white tries to get off of this pin immediately in the game. After that, knight bd2 was played and knight b6, hitting this knight over here on the c4 square. Here h3 was played, bishop h5, and bishop b3. Now you may might be considering that is this pawn we could take, is it possible that we could take this pawn? There's only one game in the database where queen into d3 are, but you would say that 17 games in the database where queen into d3 was played and white played the move knight into e5. That okay, if your bishop is going to take my queen, then I'm going to take your queen. Here the main move is queen f5 and knight comes back to e f3, and in this game, the roundabout, there are draw ratios is higher than the winning ratio for white and black out. White has been 29% of games and black has been 14% of games roundabout. So we go back to our main move which was played in the game. After bishop b3, king h8 was played. K. Sasikaran is planning to play this move f5, so he brought the king to h8, that's why. Knight e4, a standard move. Still in the, we are still in the theory. And knight d7. The problem behind over here is that black has tried this move, bishop to b6 over here twice before, and black has lost both of that games. this move bishop to e7 is also possible. Even this move bishop d6 is also possible, but the ratio of white winning is higher than the black, but not in this sequence of bishop d6. There are only three games in the database where this move bishop d6 was played and the score was equal. One was win with white and one was win with black and one was draw. Here, instead of it moving this bishop to d6 or e7, Sasikiran played the move knight to d7, and now we are out of the theory. This is a new game. After that, bishop d5 was played immediately. This is the type of thinking we should keep in mind. The weaker players, the players below 2300, 2400, 2200 or 2000 are the players who are 1700, 1800 are still below us. That we have to take advantage of our pieces better placement. And this is what Aliza Froda did in this game, and he played the move immediately bishop to d5, hitting this knight over here. That I'm going to disturb your pawn structure by taking this knight over here, and after you take the pawn over here, your pawn structure is messed. So f5 was played immediately, and that was the inner accuracy. I would say not say that it is the inner accuracy. Actually, this is a mistake. Instead of it, bishop d6 was better. Once again over here. After that, knight g3, hitting this bishop on h5, bishop g6 and d4. After e into d4, c into d4 and rook e8. And this sequence of the moves was better for black. The game is equal over here. As all the black pieces are developed and white pieces are also developed. And the game is equal. So the f5 was played by Sasikiran. And here, Aliza Froda immediately had a look that this juicy scare is for his knight. This e3 scare. And he is going to pick one of the rocks. After that, knight eg5, h6 was played. Let's see that, is it possible that black could hold this rook over here? The problem is that he cannot. So instead of playing this, there are chances that he can hold this rook by playing this rook over here. But instead, Sasikiran went for the move h6, saying that, okay, come and exchange it. I am going to give you the exchange. Come over here. He asked the Aliza Froda roundabout by playing this move a6 that, okay, I am giving this rook exchange for your knight. After that, knight e6 was played, queen f6 and knight into f8. Instead of it, it was better to play the move d4 first over here. Okay, we go back with our game where knight into f8 was played. And after that, rook into f8 was played. Instead of it, it was better to take this with the bishop. This knight with bishop. Bishop into f8. And bishop e3, developing this bishop over here. After that, rook d8. Lining this rook to queen and this pawn on d3. White replies with b4. taking this care away from the knight and going saying that I'm going to push this pawn to b5. So we go back to our game where rook into f8 was played, and after that d4 was played, immediately hitting the center. e4 was played, and instead of e4, it was better to play bishop b6 here, still keeping the eye on this diagonal and this f7, f2 pawn. After d into e5, knight c into e5, bishop f4, and knight c6. This was the better sequence of the moves which Sasikiran could have opted for. And black has still fired in this position, although he's a lot of tempo down. So after the move which was played in the game, e4 by black, after the move d4 by white, d into c5 was played, because this knight can't be moved. So here Aliriza Feroza thought that why not I give up this queen and take three pieces or two pieces of black for this queen over here. And he went for it. He went with his plan. After d into c5, knight d5 was played. Again hitting this knight and stressing that I am going to take your queen over here. This was the critical movement of the game. Instead of here knight d5, black would have opted for bishop into f3. But the sequence was the same, because now he is going to be pieced down, g into f3, knight c e5, f into e4, f4. And now you may see that white is clearly a piece down. Sorry, black is clearly a piece down. So he went for this. After that, knight into e5, giving away the queen, bishop into d1, knight d7, queen d8, going back. And there is no not possible to save this bishop. So attacking this knight and bishop first. B into c6. First, after rook e8. Here this is a critical moment of the game. If pawn takes the bishop, then knight into f8, and after queen into f8, rook into bishop, white is completely winning. He has two rooks for the queen and one extra bishop also, and white's position is completely winning over here. So instead of going for this, black understood that he had played the move rook e8 first, and after rook into bishop, b into c6, bishop f4, and queen h4. Here black understood that he cannot take this cannot hold on to this pawn. He have to get creative, as white's position of his pieces, pawns, is better. White has two pieces for rook, and he has two rooks also for the queen. So here Sasikiran understood that he would have to be optimistic, get into fancy nature to get something out of this position. So after queen h4, bishop into c7, and e3 was played. F into e3, rook into e3, and rook d4. Immediately controlling this rank and this file. Queen e7 was played. Here, black would have gone for with the move queen, rook e1 check, but after rook, queen into e1 check, and king h2. White's position is extremely good. He could went for some types of moves like bishop f4, then these moves, which happens in the game, and then this after take, he can move this pawn to queen, and actually this plan happened in the game also, and black queen can't do anything. He does not have better skills. So Satsukira moved his queen back to queen e7. After that, bishop f4 was played, hitting the rook on e3, rook e2, and b4. Computer says this is a W move, but I will go with the Reza Feroza move. And this move strengthens this pawn chain. So queen e8 was played, and that was basically a mistake. Instead of it was better to play the move g5, immediately hitting this bishop over here. And after knight e5, because there is, where are you going to place your bishop? If you try to save it by playing the move bishop to c7, then the game is equal. Rook into g2 check, king into g2, queen e2 check, king g1, queen e3 check, and this is a draw. So instead of saving this bishop over here, it was better to play the move knight e5. Now black can't take this bishop over here because of this check on g6 and picking up this queen on e7. So after that, rook into knight, bishop into rook, and queen into bishop. And this game is extremely complicated, although white has a great advantage over here, but this is extremely complicated game. May swing to any side, although white has the winning chances, more winning chances than black in this position. So b4 was played in the game, then queen e8 was played, which was a mistake, and I highlighted that. After that, rook f1, queen e6, and rook f2, and these all squares are covered. Black gains nothing from giving this check, and he is forced to take the rook on f2, which was happened in the game. And rook into f2, king into f2, rook queen into a2 check, taking this pawn and giving the check over here, bishop d2, and this rook is protected by this pawn on c3, and this bishop is also protected, and this knight is also protected over here, and this queen can't do anything over here. White has enormous advantage in this position. These minor three pieces. Queen e6 was played and c4 was played. Aliriza is saying that I'm going to play moves. After take, I'm going to make this pass pawn. So here, Satsukiran played the move a6 and bishop f4 was played, bringing the bishop to this diagonal again, tying this diagonal. Queen e7 was played and b5, creating a passed pawn. A into b5, c into b5, and queen e6 was played. That if you take this pawn, I'm going to take this with queen, but here Aliriza played the move e6. Okay, I'm going to make this the passed pawn. Queen b3 was played, bringing the queen over here to give checks and king g1, and this was a great move by Eliza Closa, that he is going to bring his king to h8, where there will be no checks by the black. After that, g5 was played, and if this move was played before, at the time where I explained the reason, now this move does not do anything. Bishop d2 was played, g4 was played, and I'm going to give you people time to pause the video and think of the Alireza Firoza move, that what he played in this game and which was a tremendous move. So kindly pause the video and think. I hope you have seen the move which was played in the game, but if you have not seen, then no problem. We need more practice. And the move which was played in the game was rook b4. I am giving away all the pieces and going to make this queen, and you cannot stop me from it. Black tried a little bit, queen d1 check, king h2, and here black cannot take this bishop, because after that pawn moves to b2, queen into rook, then this pawn moves to b8 with check to king, and after that this queen will have to take this queen and knight into queen. I will put this on the board position. Queen into bishop, pawn b6, queen into rook, b8 queen check, queen into queen, knight into queen, after that king to g7 and knight into c6, and here white is completely winning. There is no way you can stop him. So we go back to our game where king h2 was played, and Sesikren made the desperate moves like g3 check, king into g3, f4 check, and king back to h2. Here, if he had taken this pawn with the bishop, this is also the win, because after that, for example, I may show this on the board. Bishop into pawn, and queen check, king g4, queen into rook, and king f5, and king is moving, going to move over here and going to make this pawn, queen, and black queen cannot stop. So after king h2, here Sesikren resigned. So this was the end of the video. If you like it, kindly like, kindly subscribe and hit the bell icon button. Thank you very much.